Today we've heard so many nice glorifications of Sri Nityananda Prabhu. I was thinking of his exalted qualities, and we've heard of how mercifully I recall that when preaching in faraway countries, and specifically Prabhupada gave me the mission of preaching in South America. Yes. Initially, when we opened our temples, the only deities ever installed there were Gordon Tai. So all we have is the mercy of the dying around us. And practically all the original temples in South America, they just have these small Gordon Tai trees. And we would pass a lot of time just chanting the dying around. One of the Lord came to me and he said, "You were chanting too much, Nityananda." And I was worried about it. But I didn't see this anymore. Then I heard in a tape, recording from Tehran, Iran, one boy asked Prabhupada, he said, "What about this chanting of Nityananda?" He asked Prabhupada. Said, "Chanting of Nityananda, this is non-different than chanting Hare Krishna." Non-different. And when His Divine Grace, the only time He went to South America was in Caracas, Venezuela, in 1975. The only time He touched His lotus feet on the whole continent of South America. And we have this small Nityananda Gauranga deities here. And this scene was also repeated when we left and he went to Glen. Those devotees remember Glen. And he saw the Nityananda Gauranga there and he started crying. Because he realized that they had come so far, he said, from Mayapur to this distant place, just to give them mercy. He was very moved. He started crying. Also, he started crying. He saw that he didn't have other deities when he went to Atlantis. Whether he stopped, he couldn't even pick the bus. He was so impressed by how merciful he was. We heard how Lord Nityananda's mercy was exhibited with the brothers Jagai and Madai. Jagai and Madai, for those who don't know, they were serial killer, rapists, and drunkards. You can understand what that means. Serial killers, rapists, and drunkards at the same time. They were, as we say in English, bad to the bone. Really bad. So that they will be saved by the mercy of Lord Nityananda means that there's no one who can be as bad. You're not bad as they can be. So anyone can get the mercy of Lord Nityananda. So I was seeing Prabhupada's example, we appreciated that they had given them mercy in faraway places and to the lowest. And Jagat Mother is Maharaj explained that they have their own samadhis where one can go visit and make darshan. They became great devotees by the mercy of the Lord. He trained them up, they became great devotees and they just served the Vaishnavas. So we have to take the Lord Nityananda's example that anybody can be converted by this sankirtan movement. All this happened because Lord Nityananda, they were doing sankirtan. They were going door to door, requesting people to chant Hare Krishna. So they were a threat to the Jagai and Madai mafia at the time. So they were a threat. So This is all coming about because they have an active Sangaton party. So we should also try to give the mercy to the fallen condition souls, follow the steps of the Lord and Jumanji, Arias Thakur, and try to make them mercy. Anybody who can do this, giving people Krishna consciousness as Prabhupada, they will make the mercy of the Lord and Jumanji. And then you can actually serve the Lord Chaitanya and his movement.
Nityananda is no different from Balaram. Actually, identical. But there's one difference, which is important. The character of Balaram, we know in many past times, he can become a king just like Yamuna did not want to come voluntarily. He dragged her forcibly with his plow. And there are other pastimes where Balaram exhibited his strong character of becoming supremely angry, and like in the case of Arjuna Sutta, even killing somebody for being impudent. But Nityananda Prabhu, he has a special quality that makes him different from Balaram. Akrola Paramananda Nityananda Raya. He's the supreme bliss personified that never becomes angry. And of course we heard about the pastimes of Jaya and Madaya. And if anybody hits you, not necessarily with a positive outcome, even a slight insult, what to speak of becoming physically aggressive, very difficult that we not react with anger. So Nityananda Prabhu, without any doubt, there was sufficient cause to be angry. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he became angry, supremely angry. He called for his chakra to kill the offender. But Nityananda Akrola, no anger at all. So, Srila Prabhupada is known to be empowered by Nityananda Prabhu to distribute Krishna consciousness and accept people who are just like Jagannatha, or even worse. And now I've heard that practically they are so bad that it's very difficult that anybody could be worse. I dare to say that nowadays, even 40 years ago, when we came to Krishna consciousness, I think we were worse. And today, things have degraded even further. Prabhupada says in some of his purports that Nityananda Prabhu, he saved Jagannatha, one pair of very bad people. But we are encountering hundreds and thousands of Jagai and Madais. And I think we can honestly say worse quality. So Prabhupada being empowered by Nityananda Prabhu, he shows the mercy of Nitai to an even greater extent, accepting Jagais and Madais multiplied in all respects, in number and in their qualities. So the glories of Nityananda Ram are being propagated and being increased, augmented day after day by Srila Prabhupada's preaching through his books and through his followers. And in this way we can, without any doubt, appreciate the glories of Nityananda, who was able to empower a living entity with such mercy that his glory is increasing and increasing unlimitedly. Hare Krishna. Nityananda Ram Ki Jai.
As far as I know, this first occasion of offering Vyasa Puja, words of glorification to Lord Nityananda and his appearance day. I couldn't help but remember the past time where Lord Chaitanya said, we should have the Vyasa Puja ceremony at Srivasa's house. The tiki is tomorrow, can you arrange? And Srivasa Thakur said, yes, of course. When it came time for offering the garland and some mantras of worship to Sri Guru, Vyasadeva, Srivasa gave the garland to Nityananda. And Nityananda stood there looking a little bewildered. He muttered some incoherent words, and then finally he offered the garland to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So in the same way, I'm certainly bewildered. Only mine is not transcendental, it's the world of nature and my own ignorance. So I pray for your blessings and the blessings of Srila Prabhupada that I might say something worthy of you. Nityananda Prabhu ki. So, Srila Prabhupada says we offer prayers to the Supreme Lord. And if we offer the prayers that have been uttered by the great Acharyas, we know for a fact that those prayers are very pleasing to the Lord. So I'd like to share some thoughts or words of glorification to Srila Nityananda Prabhu that were voiced by Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur in an article he wrote about Lord Nityananda Prabhu. Lord Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, we all know that. And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is that same Lord Krishna, one and the same. Lord Krishna does not teach us by his example. For Krishna, it's more like, do what I say, not what I do. We all know Lord Krishna is a transcendental liar, a cheat, a thief, a debaucher. We cannot imitate or follow Lord Krishna's example in this way. But Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is the perfect example of a completely surrendered servant of Krishna. And in this way, we can follow not only the teachings of Lord Chaitanya, but also his example. When Lord Nityananda appeared, he was senior to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Lord Chaitanya deputed him here in Navadvipa to go door to door and ask everyone without exception to please chant the holy names of Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Without the mercy of Lord Nityananda, we cannot even approach Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. The spiritual consciousness of the jiva, the tiny individual soul, is incapable of directly approaching the divinity, Lord Krishna or Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But Lord Chaitanya is so kind that he deputed Nityananda to be the intermediary, to give us his blessing so that it would be possible to approach, to worship and serve Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We see this in the pastime of Raghunath Das Goswami. Hard as he tried, he could not achieve the shelter of the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya until he got the mercy of Lord Nityananda Prabhu. So this power of Lord Nityananda, it is completely spiritual. It's really inconceivable because he is kindly bestowing this mercy, offering it to every and all conditioned souls, regardless of their fallen, conditioned nature. The power or the mercy of Lord Nityananda is identical with the power of the Shat Guru or the Eternal Spiritual Master. And simultaneously, the power, the Shakti of the Spiritual Master is identical with the revealed scriptures. But there is a difference between the revealed scriptures and the mercy or instructions of the Spiritual Master. We cannot directly approach the revealed scriptures by our intellect alone. Only by the mercy of the spiritual master can we be given the gift of understanding the essence of the Bhakti Shastras, which of course is complete unalloyed surrender to the Supreme Lord and His servants. So we try to avail ourselves of this mercy of Lord Nityananda through the mercy of the spiritual master. What do I know about Lord Nityananda? If it were not for the mercy of Srila Prabhupada, I wouldn't have a clue. I'd just be a dancing dog, dancing merrily towards my destruction and entrance into hell. But by the mercy of Lord Nityananda, he empowered his divine representative, Srila Prabhupada, to go and deliver so many doomed dancing dogs. And this is still going on to this day. The power of Lord Nityananda is openly accessible to all, but we have to have some desire. If someone, Srila Prabhupada gave the example, is trying to give you $1 million and you keep your hands folded, and you don't open them and accept graciously with gratitude, then what can the bestower of that wealth do? So Lord Nityananda is more merciful than Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He wants so very much of us to surrender to the spiritual master, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He wants so very much. But we have this dirty heart. And as we heard a couple of days ago, we're afraid to surrender to the spiritual master, Krishna. So what to do? We have to hear from the spiritual master and associate with those who are following the instructions of the scripture, the process given by Lord Nityananda. In that association, in that hearing, our hearts become purified. We become infected with the desire to surrender unto Guru, Vaishnava, and Krishna. So on this auspicious day of Lord Nityananda's appearance day, we beg to the best of our ability take advantage of this association that we're surrounded by, that we hear attentively, and that we pray to assimilate and to follow, not just to gather facts and figures of scripture, or to look very nice, clean, puppy, etc., but to surrender our heart, our independence, our desire to serve at the lotus leadership of Prabhupada and his followers, that they might be pleased with us. Deal with this as they may. Words of kindness, words of chastisement. If we take both equally as a benediction from the spiritual master, we can become a worthy recipient of the mercy that they are offering. And so on this auspicious day, we pray at the feet of the Vaishnavas, at the feet of Srila Prabhupada, the Lord Nityananda, that we surrender our false ego, our independence, and try to develop this compassion, this desire to follow the mission of Srila Prabhupada and the Lord Nityananda and Chaitanya. Srila Prabhupada,